this? We're working on linear equations. What's this mess? This is just terrifying. I mean, you know, when I was a little kid, I had this strategy for dealing with scary stuff. Maybe it'll work here. You know, as a little kid, I just close my eyes and the scary stuff would be gone. Let's try that here. Ah, didn't work. Didn't work. It's still there. You know, I've got an algebra strategy that works just like this. It works just like closing your eyes and making the scary stuff go away. Here's how it works. This is scary. This is scary. The square root of r plus 7 thing, just terrifying. We're going to make it go away. We're going to say x equals the square root of r plus 7. All right? And then we're going to put in x everywhere we see this square root of r plus 7. And then our equation just becomes 3x minus 17 equals 3 minus x. Poof. The scary stuff is gone. Just like that. We use a nice little substitution here to substitute for the scary stuff, and we turn this scary equation into this harmless little linear equation. We add x to both sides, we add 17 to both sides, we get 4x equals 20, so x equals 5. And then we write down 5 and we're wrong, because the problem doesn't ask us to find x, it asks us to find r. But we have found that x is 5, so we've taken this terrifying equation, we put 5 in up here, and we have 5 equals the square root of r plus 7. That's a lot less scary than this. From here I can say, hey, wait a second, square root of r plus 7 is 5. Well, let's see, that must mean that r plus 7 is 25. Because we know that the number whose square root is 5 is 25, because you square 5, you get 25. So r plus 7 must have been 25 in order to make this equation true. And we just subtract 7 from both sides, and we get r equals 18. Now, maybe that seemed a little shady to you. We should test it. We can always check our work on equations by sticking the numbers back into the equation. So let's see what happens here. We have r equals 18. We put that in here. We have 18 plus 7 is 25. Just like planned, the square root of 25 is 5. 5 times 3 is 15. 15 minus 17. We get negative 2 on this side. All right, let's see what we get on the other side. Square root of, put our 18 in. 18 plus 7 is 25. Square root of 25 is 5. 3 minus 5 is negative 2. It checks out, and we got that one right. Let's move on to the next problem. This one's at least, it's not nearly as scary as that last one. I mean, the only difference here is that little exponent. It says to solve the equation. What does that mean? Oh yeah, it means basically the same thing as this. Here we wanted to find all values of r that satisfy this. That's exactly what this means, except we're looking for t. Solve the equation means find all values of t that satisfy this equation. Now, maybe that t squared scares you, like that square root of r plus 7. It doesn't look quite as scary, but if it scares you, we know how to make the scary thing go away. We'll assign a variable to the scary thing, and now we can write the equation as just 4 times 40 minus y equals 13 minus y. Now I can expand this product on the left. 4 times 40 is 160, minus 4 times y equals 13 minus y. And now we can add 4y to both sides, subtract the 13 from both sides, we get 147 equals 3y. Divide both sides by 3, y is 49. Now of course, we're not looking for y, we're looking for t. Solve the equation doesn't mean find the values of y, there's no y up there, we need t. Y equals 49, that means t squared equals 49. So now you write down 7, and you're not completely correct. Solve the equation means we have to find all values of t that work. 7 works, but so does negative 7. Both of these values satisfy this equation. So whenever you see that a squared in an equation, you got to be thinking, there may be two solutions out there. There are going to be two solutions to this equation. And you might be thinking, I'm trying to trick you. You might be right. But you got to watch out for this. Whenever you have variable squared equals to a constant, you're going to have two solutions unless that constant is 0. You got a 0 sitting over there. You just got 0. But you got 49. I've got two solutions, 7 and negative 7. Of course, we can test that. Let's go ahead and test that. Whichever one we put in here, 7 or negative 7, when we square it, we get 49. 40 minus 49 is negative 9, times 4 is negative 36. Over here we have 13 minus whichever one of these we put in here, when we square it, we're going to get 49. 13 minus 49, once again, negative 36. Now, let's take a look at what this solving this problem without this little kid, make the scary thing go away, crutch, sitting in the middle of the problem. We didn't need to use that. Once you get comfortable with these sorts of equations, you won't use that at all. You'll just go 4 times 40 is 160, minus 4 times t squared equals 13 minus t squared. You'll subtract the 13 from both sides. You'll add the 4t squared to both sides. You get 147 equals 4t squared minus t squared. So that means 147, subtract t squared from 4t squared, you're going to be left with 3t squared. Divided by 3, we have 49 equals t squared. We have a square equals to a positive constant here. We know what that means. There are two solutions. T equals 7 and t equals negative 7 are both solutions to this equation. They're both solutions to this equation. We've solved the equation. And we're done.